climbing to the top. You're finally almost there. You finally reached the top of Mount Everest. No, wait a second. It's not Mount Everest. No, in fact, you finally reached the top of Mount Cardio Hill, located in parking lot 7. So now that you reached the top, your legs are probably like tired. You're breathing heavily, like, as I would know, and I expect that many of you would know, like, not to offend anyone. So, as many of you already may be aware, running is very beneficial for your health. But exactly how is it beneficial for your health, you may ask? So, by listening to my presentation, I hope that you all learn the benefits of running and that you are more intrigued to run yourself. So today I will talk about how running can reduce stress, it can get you to achieve runner's high. Secondly, I will talk about how it benefits your immune system. And finally, I will talk about how it improves your cardio health. So many of you may not be aware or depending, running helps your stress because after you run, or during your run, your brain releases endorphins that are like natural painkillers that affect your brain for the better. So according to J.K. Matthews, in the article Why Exercise Makes You Happy, published in January 2016, he explains that endorphins are, they are natural painkillers for your brain. They reduce your stress because they are natural painkillers, basically for your brain. My next point, runner's high. As it sounds, it is basically like getting high off marijuana in a way. Coincident. So then runner's high is where in that moment of your run, when you just completed a long, tedious workout, you think you're in the middle of it. And out of nowhere, you just feel like you can keep running forever. You feel like you're on top of the world, and it's an amazing feeling. I can tell you that myself. So now that I have, runner's high, it is one of the amazing feelings you get, and that is a very needed key for yourself when you're running long mileage or very hard workouts. Now that I have talked about how stress and runner's high, I want to talk about the immune system and how it benefits from running. So the immune system, I'll admit that after a hard workout, you're gonna feel really tired, and that you're gonna be a little more open to sicknesses and viruses. So please be careful. However, after like a day of rest and very good rest, you will find yourself and your immune system getting better over through the course of many workouts. So Roy Stevenson, author of the article "How Running Can Benefit Your Health," he has a master's in exercise physiology. So he explains to us how running, you have to be cautious because of the downsides of it, such as getting sick, as I previously mentioned. So he suggests you get rest in between from 3 to 72 hours. In between that break, you have to be very careful and just relax yourself, get some very good sleep. So now that I've talked about the immune system, I want to go over how running will benefit your cardio immensely. So running, it's basically running. You run to get faster, you run to grow longer, you run to feel good about yourself. You're gonna lose a lot of weight, you're gonna feel more confident, and heck, you could even like run some really good times. So Emma Watkins, the author of the article, "The Effects of Jogging and That Affect Your Blood Flow." So she explains that running consistently, mileage, well, that depends for the person, but it increases your blood flow, your heart rate, that it expands out through your body. And that is very beneficial because it lowers your heart rate, so you are more relaxed in many points throughout the day. So you're more relaxed. So you are less likely to get heart attacks because you you are much more calm. Next, I want to talk about how John Lea, author of How Do Muscles Grow and the Science of the Muscles. So his article was published in September 2013. Although maybe a few years, it may have been published a few years ago, it is still very general information that many researchers have found upon to be very true. So as we all know, when you work out, your muscles are stressed. Because of that stress, the muscle fibers, they kind of like, they start to get broken down. So they, as soon as, after you get some needed rest, they start repairing themselves, and that's how they expand bigger. So with running, really, you do need some upper body training, but it's mostly, you're gonna benefit from your legs, and I have to tell you, like, your legs really expand. Mm-hmm. Like, they get muscular. So now that I have talked about how running benefits, reduces your stress, and that if you can achieve runner's high with it, then I talked about how it can benefit your immune system because it makes you stronger to viruses and such. And then finally I talked about how your cardio will get really good. So from listening to my speech, I hope you all learned the benefits from running, and I hope that you are more engaged to run on your own. So the next time you are at Cardio Hill, you're climbing up those stairs, 5 minutes to the top, I don't want you all to be conquered by that hill. I want you to conquer it.